I received an email today from a SmartThings staff member, and I pulled together this video to provide you with an important update about progress towards the transition to the new Edge drivers. Effective Tuesday, April 26, SmartThings will begin rolling out the Edge drivers in support of all newly onboarded Zigbee, Z-Wave, and LAN devices that are connected to the SmartThings hub. These drivers run locally on the hub and deliver improved reliability and reduced latency compared to the cloud-based device handlers known as Groovy device type handlers. The steps required to onboard or add new devices with Edge drivers is unchanged from the existing experience. According to the developers, you should not need additional steps to complete the process. This transition marks the start of a gradual process that will include a small number of devices initially, but will expand to cover more devices over the coming months. SmartThings developers have provided some answers to some anticipated questions in a FAQ section of the article. Link to that article is provided below. I will provide you with a brief summary of information contained in that FAQ section. To use the Edge-enabled devices with SmartThings, you'll need a compatible SmartThings hub with firmware version 0.038.000 or greater. To determine your hub's current firmware version, find your hub in the devices list and tap on the hub's tile. Next, tap on the ellipsis, which is the three dots in the upper right-hand side of your screen. Then tap on the word information. Your hub's firmware version is listed under your hub's name. Your existing hub connected devices, those which you have installed previously, will not be transitioned to Edge drivers. Only devices that are being newly onboarded will have support of the new Edge drivers. In other words, existing devices will not automatically transition to Edge drivers at this time. If you wish to convert your current devices to use the Edge drivers, you must manually transition the device by using the following developer resources, which I included in links below. By clicking on those links, you can access developer documentation for SmartThings Edge, as well as sample code and a list of current Edge drivers. The developers invite you to start a thread or reply to existing threads in the SmartThings community with questions or feedback on building or using Edge drivers. To identify an Edge-enabled device in the SmartThings app, you'll want to use the following steps. First, open up your SmartThings app and select the device. Then tap on the ellipsis at the top right. You will see that Edge-enabled devices will list the word driver as an option in the selection menu. Please note that you can follow the link below titled SmartThings Edge Driver List to see the current list of SmartThings Edge drivers to determine if a device has a supported Edge driver. If you do not transition your devices to Edge drivers before Groovy support ends, this date is to be determined in a future announcement, those devices will not communicate with the SmartThings platform until they have been re-onboarded or migrated to Edge drivers. If you log into your online SmartThings account and you note that an Edge-enabled device is showing as a cloud-connected device, be aware that this is due to a known bug with the Graph IDE tool. If your device has an Edge driver, it will be running locally through your hub. SmartThings has stated that this current announcement is the first of many that will be made in the upcoming months. These announcements will be made as they complete the conversion away from the Groovy device type handlers. I will be keeping you informed of these announcements as we continue our transition to the new locally based Edge drivers. If you have not yet subscribed, take an opportunity to do this, and that way you'll be informed as updates occur. I'd be interested in your thoughts about this transition, so take a moment to comment below. Until next time, keep automating, and God bless.